workplace environment generally. You could even talk about policies, you know, things that affect business in Nigeria. It could be policies within Nigeria, it could be outside Nigeria. Everything that has to do with making money and making money in a favorable environment. That's what we talk about here on the show. Now, you can, of course, join the conversation as usual. We encourage it. It's on 0813-331-3172. 0813-331-3172. That's the number to call into. Now, what are we talking about today? I have a guest in the studio as usual, and today we are looking at the NECA 2024 Job and Employability Fair. NECA 2024 Job and Employability Fair. I think we had NECA had this event also sometime last year, so it's another one is coming up, and our guest to help us talk about this is Mrs. Omowale Ogunrinde. She's the Managing Director, Field of Skills and Dreams, VTE Ikeja. Managing Director, Field of Skills and Dreams, VTE Ikeja. She has been with us before. You're welcome once again to the show. Thank you for coming.
Thank you, madam.
All right, so we are talking about NECA, the job fair. What exactly is a job fair?
Thank you. To the average person, and honestly, in very simple terms, is just bringing job seekers together with employers.
Okay.
And they come together in a same space, and easy service for the employers, because what they are looking for has come to meet them, and for the job seekers, what they are looking for has also come to meet them. So it's not just a fair like a jamboree. It is actually offering very good and qualitative service to the society at large, to employers, and even to the job seekers. Whether the job seekers get employed or not does not really make a difference, because the exposure alone to being interviewed, to being groomed, helps them a lot. However, from past experience on the NECA job fairs, they actually get hired.
Oh, that's cool. That's really cool. So, the goal generally, is it just to hire and employ? What's the general goal, apart from that, of this fair?
There are very many set objectives, but I like to speak to the average person who is listening. If you're looking for a job and you're ready to work, the job fair is a place for you to go. You apply online and you get enrolled. It's absolutely free. So the objective is to make it easier for job seekers to find jobs. One. The second one that I would say, aside from what is stated, is that for the employers as well, it just makes it easier for them to have a one-on-one interaction with the kind of persons that they are looking for to hire. Employers would always complain, oh, we have 1,000 applications and not even one is employable. Mm-hmm. However, with the NECA job fair, there would have been a pre-screening, you know, which makes it easier to match people to the kind of roles that employers had advertised. So, in the simplest of terms, it is just to ensure that employers find it easier to hire, and also makes it easier for job seekers to have a direct interface with the employers.
You talked about pre-screening.
Yes.
How is this pre-screening done?
Okay. The process for the job fair for employers is that employers would apply to NECA to be able to have a stand. I'm sure you know that there are over a million employing companies in Nigeria, so NECA cannot take all. You don't have to be a NECA member as an employer organization to apply. It's open, it's online, open to everybody who is an employer who is seeking for paper. So when you apply, you specify the roles, because like I said, it's not a jamboree.
Yeah.
So if you're looking for account officer entry level, you state it. If you're looking for interns, you state it. If you're looking for factory managers in specific sectors, you state it. So there are specified roles that the employers would fill in their own firms. Now, when the job seekers apply, normally you have thousands of them applying. Some truly amongst the job seekers don't even know what they're looking for. But because you already have a portfolio of roles that are open, you now begin to screen through, and that is what NECA does and their partners. They screen through all those applications and begin to merge them with the potential employer. So if an employer, for example, I remember last year, an employer wanted over 100 interns, and they were able to get, because that's just entry level. So whether you studied fishery, you studied education,
it didn't matter.
It did not matter to such an employer. So for that kind of employer, you can line up 1,000 people for them to interview. Yeah. It's easier. So that
okay, so the interview takes place at that
right
point
at
there.
Yes. Oh, so it's okay. a 2-day, this year it's a 2-day job fair. Day one is actually a social service that NECA will be offering to all job seekers. So day one is going to be virtual, and it's going to be a training that prepares unemployed persons for the workplace. So they'll be teaching on how to prepare a proper CV. They'll be teaching on communication skills at an interview. They'll be teaching about what is the green economy, because the focus this year is actually to give access to green economy jobs. And now, so day one, online, they're ready to take as many people as apply to come online and attend a whole day of virtual training on various sectors that will make them more confident, more prepared to come to the physical job fair. And now the second event is the physical job fair, where there will be one-on-one interviews. Last year, I know some companies came with 5 persons to be able to interview. So, yes, as they are representing the organization, because they were ready. They wanted
interns.
Yes, they wanted management trainees. So they knew they would have a whole lot of people interviewing. So they came ready and prepared. And I know they went away very happy. And this is a tier one company.
And this is quite interesting and really good, because usually when you hear about fairs like this, they are just, how would I put it, just to come and look all the stalls. Let me see you. Let me drop my card. Let me see you and things like that.
Not at all. Last year, NECA has been doing this since 2020, I believe. But last year, my organization was directly involved in the planning and all of that. And I can say for sure that a few of the tier one companies, I won't mention names, actually hired. They did not hire on the spot. They interviewed, and then they created opportunities for second interviews and third interviews, and they hired. And one of those companies has actually come back even before this year's fair to say, where can we get those kind of people to interview again? So it's, I started by saying, it's not a jamboree. It's not just for the sake of dropping your cards. No, the activity, the action, the involvement is thorough, both for job seekers and for the employers.
Now, I want you to help us talk a little about the challenges in this, in the job, in the employment space, because you did say they had to come back to NECA to ask for that fare to get somebody like they did the last time, that company. So, which means that, is it that they were not looking before, it was so difficult to get in an ordinary free employer space?
You know, like I mentioned, if a big company, or even a small company, opens up an advert now for workers, you are going to get thousands of applications, some relevant, some not relevant. And it just makes it impossible for you to really move ahead. So much work has been done. But with the job fair, a lot of the work has been done. So if you're saying you're looking for a specific type of machinist, the pre-screening would have cut off
that person. That's just applying.
So if you give me 10 people now, then at least you've made my work easier to just know that out of this 10, all of them are professional machinists. I will be able to get the one I want. No, so it's not because they cannot advertise, but they just found the process easier and more productive. And so why not? Why throw away a good idea? And why not continue to just use that same route. Okay. Yes.
That's good. You talked about the focus. You talked about green job, green economy, green job. Can you explain what that is?
Of course, the focus of the whole world now is we are kind of going green, you know, trying to reduce all the emissions mm-hmm. and all of that. And truly in Nigeria, I would say what people focus on mainly in Nigeria is the recycling part, solar installations, our own solar installations and renewable energy in Nigeria. The way I look at it, I always try to look at things from a layman's point of view, is that we're not really doing that because of climate change. We're doing that because we don't have power.
Exactly. It's not the same thing. It is true. So, you don't have power to buy petrol all the time.
You know, so it's a totally different ballgame here. However, businesses are expanding in that area. And in my own organization, since COVID, every single solar installer that we have trained, gets a job immediately after training.
Okay.
And so why does that happen? It just tells you that that sector is expanding beyond the capacity of institutions training people in that area. So the job fair this time around will be like, okay, if you have skills in that area, this is the place for you. Some of the big companies have launched new departments in their organizations focusing on all of this, and they're looking for skilled people. They're looking for somebody who even just has an idea of what we're talking about, of reducing emissions, of ensuring that it's a safe place to work for other people, members of the organization. So we expect that we're going to have nothing less than 5,000 applicants, definitely.
That's a lot.
Yes, that's a lot. We also expect that we'd have to limit the number of employers to just about 35 or 40. And it's going to be a case of first enroll, first serve. Mm. There's no selection in terms of that. But then all the jobs are going to be advertised, are going to be geared towards that. And it's not just about the jobs. It's also about the fact that we want there to be some kind of advocacy and understanding for people to come. So there's going to be a panel session and people are going to be talking about what exactly is this green economy? Mm-hmm. What are the roles that Nigerians should be playing? You know, what is the whole world saying concerning climate change, and then what are they doing? So that gradually NECA wants to set the pace. You know, they say NECA is the voice of business. They want to set the pace, you know, for that conversation in that area.
All right, if you're just tuning in and you want to contribute or ask questions, the number is 0813 331 3172, 0813 331 3172. Okay, you are listening to NECA Voice of Business, reaching you live on Radio 1 103.5 FM. We are focusing this morning on NECA 2024 Job and Employability Fair. This is something that is interesting, and I really hope everybody takes particular note of this, because from what we've been discussing and from what my guest has been saying, Mrs. Omowale Ogunrinde, the Managing Director, Field of Skills and Dreams, VTEE Keja, she has been explaining basically what we're going to gain from that. And I'm sure that a lot of people are interested in getting to know, okay, what a job. Everybody's complaining there's no job. Some people are complaining that they are not getting the right kind of people to employ. So it's like a double-edged sword here in that market. So if you have questions or you want to know more about this fair, call into 0813 331 3172, 0813 331 3172. Okay, so where does skilled labor come in here? I can't remember what they call it. I know the blue collar job and the other
white collar
job. So if I and I don't have a certificate, or I don't have the formal training, but I'm interested in this job fair. Is there space for me in this fair?
Honestly, there is, and it's the focus is actually for graduates. However, we realized that, especially last year, we realized that organizations are not looking only for graduates. Because if I'm a manufacturing company, for instance, and I'm looking for, even if they are just people to pack things in the factory, or to wrap, or to load the vehicles, or, you know, or drivers to use the trucks or something like that, it does not have to be a graduate. So it depends on what the employers and the roles that the employers advertise. So if the employers are looking for front desk officers, accounts officers, it's totally different from a factory that is said, can you just get me workmen
who can do the job I want.
So, and the truth about the matter is that no matter the organization, there is a space for the graduates and for the non-graduate in every organization. Organizations are looking for security guards. Mm-hmm. Organizations are looking for people to just open the door. Organizations are looking for people to check the trucks, logistics, and things like that. So whatever roles that are advertised is what is going to be open to all of the people who apply. However, if you apply and there are no roles for you, you will still have the benefit of the free virtual training that prepares you for the workplace, that will also give you a lot of information about various organizations where there are spaces. Some of these organizations might not have applied, but you will be given insight into routes to employment. One thing I say, and I've been in this for 20 years, 21 years this year, creating jobs. To God be the glory, internationally recognized organization by several international organizations. There are jobs in Nigeria. Our own trainees don't look for jobs. Jobs are waiting for them. So when people say there are no jobs, it's because there's really no information as regards what the opportunities are and what our youths are supposed to be doing. And that is one of the gaps that this NECA job fair is trying to fill. Is it sufficient? No. But at least NECA is trying to reduce the burden of unemployment for the young persons and also support the employers.
That's really nice. So apart from this, just this direct connection to the employers and all these trainings, what will the job seeker take away from this fair?
That's it. Every job seeker that applies would have that free training. Teaching you how to write a CV, teaching you how to communicate, whether at the job fair interview or wherever you go, teaching you and exposing you to the opportunities that are available in the job market for the kind of jobs that you may be looking for. Even teaching you business ideas that you overlook and feel that, oh no, I need money. Because every young person will say, or even old, will say, oh, I need money to start a business. No, invariably you don't need money to start a business. That's not the first thing you need. So the job fair, the opportunity, once you enroll for free, you enroll, even if you don't get the kind of role or you don't have the capacity for the kind of role that employers are looking for, you will be trained online one full day for free, and then you will go away informed. An informed person stops being ignorant. An informed person stops looking around for the right door. You will be pointed in the right direction of how to go about your job search.
Is there any form of diversity in this job fair?
Oh, yes.
And how does that play out?
Number one is for male and female. And I'm happy to say that we have a lot of female filling the technical roles now. Mm-hmm. And I'm sure you know that even a lot of the organizations are looking for more women to grow quickly and lead the organizations. You know, women have a lot of intuition and all of that. Not just that, people with disabilities, some of the organizations also need to meet certain
quota.
Exactly. So it's an opportunity for them to say, oh, okay, I want somebody who has some form of disability. We can create roles for them and all of that. So I'm actually looking forward to that happening this year. And we have some of the organizations who have indicated interest, even though they have not confirmed that they will be out to see if they can hire people like that. So it's an opportunity for people who have a little, and truly they are not disadvantages nowadays.
Yeah,
you know,
they're just
not. They're just different, you know. So to attend the job fair, and NECA is very well prepared to receive them.
Right, so we've been talking a lot about the pros and the advantages for the job seeker.
Yes.
What about the employers, the companies? How are you enticing them? What are they? You could easily have maybe got it from word of mouth from somebody. So what is their, why should they participate?
The kind of organizations that participate, they don't employ by word of mouth. They know they spend millions to go through the recruitment process. You know, they probably hire consultants. Mm-hmm. They have to advertise with a lot of money. They have to have a whole department screening the thousands or millions of applications. So when somebody is doing that, and that's why a tier one company, like I said last year, came with 5 people, you know, to do that, because it was like, wow, this is bonanza, let's go.
Yes, very ready.
You know, so they not only just come, they collect the CVs. And you know, the good thing about it for employers is not just a one day thing. So even if you've advertised for account officer one, and in the process of screening, you've seen somebody and you said, oh, wow, this person is likely to make a good CRO. Mm-hmm. You keep the records of that person on file. You have easy and direct access to all those CVs, to all those persons, you know. And then it's also a training ground for some HR companies as well, because some of their HR officers have never actually had to interview like 10 or 20 or 30 people at once. So for the companies, it's a win-win. It's what you would rather spend a lot of money on being brought to you for free, and then helps you to interact more with people, helps you to also understand where else can we create opportunities for young people to work in our organization. And then for some, they helps them to bring in a lot of interns, a lot of marketers. You know, I know a company last year that took away well over 300 CVs. They contacted us even afterwards. They took away over 300 CVs. They contacted all of these people, and then they now went ahead to hire. They even went ahead to have an event for these 300 and something people, and they hired a lot of them as marketers. So for the organizations, I actually see they don't have anything to lose. It's actually a bonanza
for
the organization. And also, it helps them to interact with one another. You know, HR directors or HR managers from various organizations, mm-hmm, have an opportunity to meet one another.
See how it's been done
and all of that. Yes.
Okay, 0813-331-3172. We'll take a break. We'll be right back. Stay with us.
Coordinating Committee, FSRCC, in collaboration with the National Broadcasting Commission, NBC, wishes to draw the attention of the public to the activities of illegal financial operators, IFOs. This is Radio 1. Radio 1. 103.5 FM.
All right, it's still NECA, Voice of Business, reaching you live on Radio 1, 103.5 FM. Remember, we are talking about the NECA 2024 Job and Employability Fair. And in the studio with me, I have, Mrs. Omowale Ogunrinde. She's the Managing Director, Field of Skills and Dreams, VTE, in Ikeja. I think we've not actually mentioned when this fair is. And I think that's one of the first things people want to know.
Okay, this fair is going to happen in May, on the 14th of May and 15th of May. Those are the days for the fair. NECA, social media pages, LinkedIn, Instagram, Facebook has a lot of adverts about this, so you can go online and check this out. And for the organizations that are interested in participating, there is also the opportunity for you to exhibit. So when you have your stand, you can exhibit your product, you can have an opportunity to talk about what exactly you do. And if you are big on CSR, you can also talk about the things that you do for the community and the society. It's open to manufacturers, to financial institutions, to social service organizations, vocational training centers. It's open to everybody, you know, ICT, whatever, wherever you find yourself, sports and all of that, because the advert for job seekers is going to be open for all, and it's not going to be restrictive, particularly those who are in the green economy sector, whether you are doing waste management, whether you are trying to do energy efficiency, resource management, whatever. So it's open to everybody. It's also open to employment agencies, and this is a giveaway for you, because this is also an opportunity for you to be able to find the kind of people you are looking for. So for the employers, it's going to help you to connect with other people, connect with your colleagues, and then connect with a diverse pool of talented individuals who have the skills that you're actually looking for. Like I said, one company last year has come back again to say, please, where can we get the same kind of people
now
that
we
you
got here
to hire last year?
That's a really for free. good for lack of a better term, testimony.
Yes, it is.
For the fair,
it
yeah.
is, it is. And then it promotes your company's brand, because definitely your advert is free of charge. It's going to be everywhere, your logos and all of that. And then all the thousands of young people that will come will get to see that, oh, you are really interested in creating opportunities for them. It also helps you to reduce the stress, like I've been hammering on, reduce the stress of
trying to hire yourself.
So NECA is open to discussions about this. They are online all of the time. Their phone lines are open. Their social media pages, you can interface with them. You can ask questions. It's the same price whether you think you are a tier 3 company or you are. It's open for all. And I will encourage a lot of startups to even
attend,
you know, because it's the screening has been done. Startups really have a problem with hiring, and so this is an opportunity for you to find the kind of skills that you've been looking for coming right to you at that job fair. Like we have said, there is no onus on you to hire on the spot. You will still have to do your due diligence. You can do a second interview, a third interview. However, the interview process would have been reduced for you and made more efficient through your participation at that job fair.
Okay, so apart from all this, are there, you know, you did mention that there are workshops for the for people who are for the job seekers.
Yes.
Are there also workshops for the companies to, as you said, some startups are finding it difficult to employ, do they have opportunities to learn the process of employment?
Yes, but not at the job fair. NECA has so many workshops that they organize all of the time for various levels of organization. Okay. So, however, you know, if a startup comes to that job fair, you will meet so many other so-called colleagues that you will be able to exchange your information, network, and tap into knowledge. That's really something that is difficult in this environment, getting to know the right person who can open the door for you, and the person might just be right beside you. So that opportunity for tier one, tier two, tier three, wherever you find yourself, to all come together in a room, you can imagine the kind of energy, the kind of networking, and there are not going to be too many. So they're just going to be the 40 lucky ones. But the kind of networking, even amongst the employers, it's something that could take other people so many years to be able to get.
Okay, so let's go back to the workshops for the job seekers. Yes. What should they expect? What are the different topics that they should be expecting to learn?
For the job seekers, for the free, the 2 days are free, but for the virtual one, there will be a section on preparing for a job interview. There will be how to prepare a winning CV, you know, because I'm sure you see a lot of CVs.
Yes,
a winning CV that somebody will look at, and even if they don't need your skill, they will not throw that CV away. They keep it on file that I'm sure I'm going to come back to.
This is an interesting one.
You're going to learn workplace etiquette. You're going to learn how to present yourself.
I think we need that workplace etiquette a lot, because we hear a lot of stories. Even if they are intelligent enough to get hired, there's just something wrong.
That's it. Yes. And, you know, sometimes that is even more important than the technical skill you have. That's it. So they're going to learn that. They're going to learn communication, workplace communication, interview communication, how to present yourself. The decision to hire or fire, 70% or more of it is taken in your first 30 seconds of presenting yourself before somebody who is going to interview you. How do you present yourself? How do you walk towards that person? How do you sit? What should be the first thing you say? When they ask you, tell us about yourself. How do you answer that question? Mm. So those are all the things that will be learned in the virtual training. And of course, even if you decide, oh, I'm not coming for the physical one, what you would have learned, and that's why we say that day one is actually NECA's biggest CSR event to the society, because they'll be training people, whether you are in Kano, whether it's virtual. Mm. So anybody who applies will get the link to that free online training.
Okay, so how do I apply? Let me
quickly
know.
So
and run there.
NECA will be sharing the links for employers to apply is open now on all NECA social media pages. And the reason that the ones for employers have opened before job seekers is because we need to know the roles
available
that are available.
Oh yeah, before we advertise to
job seekers. So in the week immediately after the Easter holidays, the application for job seekers will begin to go viral online. Just follow NECA on Facebook, on Instagram, on LinkedIn. They're going to be on radio like here as well, but just follow any of those pages and you will see the link to apply. Like I've said, it's absolutely free.
Okay, it's free and I need to apply. As in preparation for the application, what should I know? What should the job seeker know or get ready?
Information. The application is an online form. Just your information. Who are you? It's just going to be simple, straightforward. And then the roles will be there. So you know. You look at it thoroughly and you decide on which roles. You are likely to be given 3 options. Choose 3 roles that you feel you are skilled, you know, to fill. And for many, like I said, they are going to be entry-level roles and they are going to also be professional roles. So even if you feel, oh, I don't have enough experience, even though I studied accounting, I don't have enough experience to be an accounting officer, then fill in the role as an entry officer. When you get in, within a few months and you do well, you will be able to get that experience that you've been looking for. So everything is going to be very simple. However, after you have applied, you will now be invited to come for that virtual training.
Okay.
During the virtual training, you will now be told everything you need to bring for the physical interview. We've shown you how to write a CV. Quickly go and upgrade your CV to this standard. How do you dress to come? How well should your hair look? How well should your tie be? And, you know, personal hygiene, basic things like that, just to ensure that even the employers will be happy at the kind of people that will be presented to them.
Okay, most of what you talked about is for entry-level job seekers. What if I want to change my jobs? I've spent years in this particular field and I'm interested in, I'm looking for something else.
Last year, I don't have the profiles on me, but I know for sure last year we had a lot of organizations that were actually looking for financial controller, marketing controller, you know, machinists, people with experience. So entry-level jobs, yes, that's like for the crowd, but a lot of the organizations, the one of the organizations was looking for HVAC specialists. That's what you normally call RAC, refrigeration and air condition. That's what they came for. Some were looking for truck drivers, you know. So
you can't be an entry-level truck driver.
Exactly. You cannot be an entry-level HVAC specialist. Mm. You cannot be an entry-level financial controller. You know, you can't be an entry-level marketing director.
Yeah.
So, so various organizations look for various things, and that is why the employers have to apply first before those roles are advertised to the job seekers. So when you are filling your form as a job seeker, you will see some of the roles that have been advertised. And of course, if you want to change from being a journalist to being a script writer in an organization, you probably see something like that there.
That's cool. What about people who can't attend? What opportunities are there for them?
The virtual training. People who can't attend physically, then they have access to the virtual training.
I attend the virtual training and I have an opportunity. I can't attend the physical one. What do I do?
It's unfortunate because if you don't attend the physical, there's no how we can match you to the employer. So the only place where the matching comes is for the physical training. And that is why both the employers and the job seekers have to be there physically. It's a direct one-on-one meeting. So if you don't attend the physical, unfortunately, you're helpless.
All right, let's go back to when it's happening again and where.
So it's on the 14th and 15th of May, and it's happening at NECA House in Ikeja. And if you know NECA House, you know that it's big enough to take as many people as have applied to come.
Okay, thank you so much.
Thank you.
I think before we round off, I want you to emphasize again, just briefly, advantages. We talked about it a lot, and I really want people to understand this, because we're talking about there's no job, people are finding it difficult, and NECA has opened up an opportunity for us all again. So talk to the person, maybe the person that just tuned in this last minute.
Okay.
What are we talking about?
Okay, if you apply either for the job seeker or for the employer, the NECA job fair this year is going to create employment opportunities in the green economy, range of jobs, anything you can think of. Front desk and all is just creating jobs for an informed person. It's going to help to build skill, foster skill development and capacity building. You know, there's going to be knowledge sharing, there's going to be networking, there's going to be a lot of collaborations, because you're going to have a direct access to experts. We're going to have a lot of the kind of people you're looking for to ask questions are going to be there, the kind of people that can give you guidance counseling in terms of career changes, they are going to be there. It's going to bridge the gap between job seekers and employers, because it's a physical job fair, it's not a jamboree. It's actually a place where employers are coming knowing that the job they've come here to do today is to interview people who are looking for jobs. It's going to improve the economic earnings of the employable population of Nigeria. Like I said, companies hired last year. Not only did they hire, they wanted even to hire more between last year and this year's job fair. So this year we expect that it's going to be bigger, it's going to be better. The advantages are, you know, there are just too many to count. The only disadvantage or worrisome part of it is that maybe we're going to even have 10,000 applicants.
So and what are we going to do?
However, NECA has this job fair in three parts of Nigeria.
Oh, okay.
So every year. So Lagos is normally the first, and then somewhere in the north, and somewhere in the south, south, or the southeast. So if you don't get in, you can also try again
for the other,
for the other parts of Nigeria.
That's cool. Yes. That's cool. Thank you so much once again for joining us. As you know, so keep your ears peeled here on the station for at this time every Wednesday, or you can go to any NECA social media handle and get more information on how you can apply and how you can get to attend this job fair that is happening in May. Thank you so much to my guest, Mrs. Omowale Ogunrinde. Thank you so much for joining us. Remember, she is the managing director, Field of Skills and Dreams, VT in Ikeja. And I think there was a time I was like, people should go there. Because when we had a talk about the vocational training the last time we came, I was really something that I had already told my children, people are going for vocational training. Thank you once again for coming to the show.
Thank you for having me. Have a wonderful day.
Yeah, if you're for sponsorship or you want to collaborate with NECA on the show, please call Adenike on 0802-344-9145 0802-344-9145, or you can call Oluwaseun on 0816-060-0305 0816-060-0305. Thank you so much for listening. My name is Olawumi Akon, NECA Voice of Business. We'll be back same time next week. Good morning.